what I want you to do now, just for a second, I want you to turn to your neighbor. We're only going to do this for 2 minutes. And come up with a definition of bullshit. It's not so easy. Come up with a definition. This is actually going to be your first tiny little assignment. Come up with a definition or come up with examples of bullshit. You get 2 minutes. Go to work. I'm hearing great conversation, but unfortunately, this is only a one-credit class. So, okay, all right. What I'd like to do is, would anyone sort of be so courageous as to share their definition, or at least an example? All right, we had Joe right in the, we just met Joe actually getting water before this, thanks.
For me, bullshit is taking information with an intent to deceive, to convince someone of an argument regardless of what the reality is.
Taking information with the intent to deceive, that's pretty darn good.
I like it.
You pass, okay, you can go now.
All right, you're done, Joe.
All right, good, all right, what? Really good. What else? That's a hard one to up, no, I don't want to scare you guys, because. What else do we have? At least some examples. All right, I see your hand back there.
We highlighted more of the passive nature of how bullshit is so easily spread. So we came up with the definition of something that can be created intentionally, but it's actually spread more in a passive way with a disregard for things.
Oh, I like it.
Well, you guys have been reading something good. Did you read the readings before? Usually it doesn't happen.
No one read the readings. Really?
That was really good. The one I really
That's
liked,
cheating.
The what I really like about that, there were several parts of it I really liked. The part that I like the best that really fits in, at least with the way we think about it, is disregard for the truth. Now, there is this passivity, which you talk about too, which is really beautiful. Well done. Let's do one more. I got a hand up here.
Yeah, in regards to that, like, when you're a kid and you play that game like Telephone, where you sit down. Like,
yeah!
And it always gets changed. Like, at the end of this line, it's like always different than what you started with.
That's a great metaphor, too, because in that case, you're not even trying to deceive. You're trying to get the information correct around the circle, and it still sort of falls apart and sort of dissolves. By the time it gets around the circle. Great, great example.
This happens as things move through the news media. I mean, you'll have an initial primary story that's fairly reasonable, and then it'll get turned into a press release, and then someone will write a story based on the press release, and someone will make a graph based on that story, and someone will tweet the graph, and then someone will tweet about what the graph said, and by that point, you're way down the other end of the telephone line, and there's sort of no connection. We'll see some nice examples of that as the course moves forward.
That's really great. So because it's such a big class, I want to keep going through this discussion, but we need to move on.